In this video, we'll try to understand what exactly is NuGet and why do we need it. Now, the amount of frameworks and libraries, you know, from both Microsoft and non-Microsoft open sources are huge in numbers. So, for example, from Microsoft, we have MVC, we have Entity Framework, and you know, a lot of those setups and libraries which come separate. Then from, you know, open sources, you know, we have NUnit, Log4Net, etc. So as a Visual Studio developer, if you want to need to reference these frameworks or libraries, what you need to do is you need to go and search the library first thing. Second thing, you need to go and install the library or probably unzip it at some place, then reference the DLL in your Visual Studio project. If the library demands, you probably also have to make some changes, you know, to the app config file or web config file. And in case, you know, if you want to go and again, you know, remove the library from your Visual Studio project, then you have to go and again revert back the config changes. You have to go and unreference the DLL. You have to go and uninstall the library, etc. So you can easily visualize, you know, how difficult it is to add references, you know, to these libraries. And also, you know, the complete thing becomes more complicated, you know, when you have newer versions of these frameworks and libraries. So it is very difficult to track, you know, on which URL the setup is, you know, what kind of DLLs to reference and unreference, what kind of changes to be made to the config files, etc. And that's where NuGet comes into picture. So NuGet is nothing but it's a Visual Studio extension, you know, which helps us to search libraries. It helps us to locate those libraries. You know, you can download them, you know, reference them in your Visual Studio project. And automatically NuGet, you know, will make appropriate changes to the app config file and web config file depending on what libraries you have downloaded. So let me show you a simple demo of how to go and, you know, reference NUnit in your project by using the NuGet extension. So here is a simple class library project I have. And actually this class library project is nothing but it's a test project. So I'm going to go and write test cases using NUnit. So I would like to use NuGet and download NUnit, reference it in my project, but I have no idea where to get NUnit from. You know, I have no idea what DLLs to reference. I have no idea what config files to modify. So no worries. So that's where NuGet comes into picture. So first thing, go ahead, click on project, and you can see that there is a menu here saying manage NuGet packages. So click on that and go ahead and search for NUnit. So I'll just go online and I'll start searching for NUnit. So there you can see now it is going and searching, you know, where NUnit is. And you can see yes, because I searched for NUnit, he has also given me some other setups as well. But I'm interested in only this NUnit unit testing framework. So I'm going to go and click install here. And there it is. It is installed. Good. I'm going to go and close this. And now if you see here in your Visual Studio project, you can see that he has referenced the NUnit.framework DLL. So in other words, it went ahead, it downloaded the DLL into your project folder, and then it also added a reference, you know, to your class library. So now I just need to go and say here NUnit.framework and then start attributing my test cases, my test methods. So you can see, you know, that I don't have to go to Google now anymore, you know, search where NUnit is, install it, add a reference to my DLL, you know, worry about a lot of things. And the good part here is, you know, in case you want to go and uninstall it, in case you want to go and dereference the whole thing, what you can do is, again, you can just go to project here, manage NuGet packages, and then basically look at your package. So I'm going to go and say, okay, tell me what packages are there currently with me. So I have this NUnit. So what I can do now here is I can go here in my install packages and I can go and uninstall this. If I go and uninstall this again, it will go ahead, dereference, you know, the DLL, you know, remove all the changes that has been done to the app config file and ensure that your project has no more reference, you know, to this DLL. So if I click on uninstall and if I close it, you can see that now a lot of errors are popping up. So that is there because the NUnit framework is no more referenced. And if you see the class library solution explorer, you can see that the NUnit DLL is no more referenced. So again, revising, NuGet is nothing but it's a Visual Studio extension, which will help you to search, locate the library, download them, reference them in your VS project. And also, if you wanted, you can again revert back the changes by using NuGet. So next time, you know, if you have a complicated framework, must be open source or probably coming directly from Microsoft, at least first go and search in NuGet. If it is there, then, you know, you don't need to really do a lot of things manually. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what is NuGet and why do we need it. Thank you so much.